So, dear students, we were able to complete that chapter, Reach for the Top. In this chapter, we have come to know about Santosh Yadav's life. How did she aspire for her dreams? How did she fulfill her? Okay, so now today we are going to discuss question answers of this chapter. So much content is given in this chapter. Facts are right in front of you. But it doesn't mean that you copy that content and you speak your answer in the same way. You have to take hints only from the chapter. Afterwards, frame these answers in your own words. Then speak. And I'm really sorry to say the students who will not be answering me, I'm going to make them stand right in front of the camera. So that others should also come to know that what is your response in class. So don't waste your energy in useless gossips. Utilize your energy on your text so that you can score good marks. In your paper, there'll be MCQs. It doesn't mean that in MCQs, there is no need to go in detail. You have to go in depth of the text. Any of the question in any of the form can be asked. So you be prepared for that. So when you get a chance to find out any of the answer, you go through the text. Go through very, very carefully. You have to go between the lines. Okay? Straight away answers will not be asked from you in your paper. So let's discuss question answers. So the very first question that we have been given is, why was the holy man who gave Santosh mother his blessings surprised? Why? So Aditya, you tell me this answer.
The holy man was giving blessings to her mother who was wishing to have a boy child. It was her grandmother who was standing nearby. Her mother, and she said that they didn't want a boy child, and everyone got surprised, even the holy man got this.
Wait, you come here. So that online students, they should not feel aloof. They should also listen to that content. Online student, you will also be given a chance to tell the answer. So be ready for that.
The society in which Santosh family lived, their birth of the son was regarded as a blessing, and everyone sought to bless them with a son, but her mother sought a blessing for a daughter. That's why the holy man who gave Santosh mother his blessings was surprised.
Yes. Very nice. She has arranged all the points so beautifully. Now you come.
Santosh was born in a society where daughters were considered as curse and son as a blessing. When her mother was expecting Santosh, there was a traveling holy man. He saw her mother and gave her the blessing, assuming that they wanted a son. He was surprised by the words of the grandmother. She said she wanted a granddaughter, and he gave the blessing for the same.
So very nicely, she has also presented her answer. So basically, in the society where she was living, the son was considered just like a blessing and daughters were considered just like a curse. So when holy man was passing by, he was expecting that lady would definitely ask for the blessings to bless her with a son. But on the contrary, opposite happened. What happened? Because grandmother of Santosh, she told Holi to bless that lady with a girl. So it was really a surprising amazing experience for a holy man, because at that time in the society, everybody, you can say any of the pregnant or expecting lady, she was expecting from holy man to give her blessings related to that, to have a son. So it was really a surprising thing for that holy man that that lady wanted to bless her with a daughter instead of a son. Clear? So now let's move to next question. Give an example to show that even as a young girl, Santosh was not ready to accept anything unreasonable. See, the society where she was living, when she started growing up, she saw some different kind of things in her surrounding. So she was a girl, okay? She was so young, but she dared to speak against those things. She did not accept all the things which were unreasonable, and other girls of her age, they were accepting. So what was that? Yes, Divya, come. Marriage was there. Clothes, yes, dressing sense. Then education, okay? So there were so many things. So now Divya, pick up mic. Tell me this.
Santosh was a young, determined lady. She always... determined lady. She always wanted to choose a correct and a rational path. She was affirmative and wanted to influence her own decision. For example, she threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. She left home like a seagull and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi.
First step in childhood, she has taken that she enrolled herself in Delhi because she wanted to go for higher education. Another example you can take about that clothes, that in her village, every girl was wearing those traditional dresses, but she dared to wear shorts, and she opposed also that why to wear such kind of traditional dresses. So, okay. And she wanted to go for higher education. So that's why she enrolled herself in Delhi. Afterwards, she went to Jaipur also. And when her family and society was giving her pressure to get married at an early age, even the age of, at the age of 16, she opposed them. She wanted to make her, first of all, career. She wanted to get education. She did not want to get married at an early age. So these were all the things that she opposed, all these matters she opposed, and she proved herself, because when she thought that such kind of unreasonable things were going on, why to follow these unreasonable things? Clear? So who is going to tell me second answer? I can ask any of the child. Okay, Daljeet, you come. Whatever you think, I have given you 3 points. Related to clothes, related to education, related to marriage. You can talk about that. Speak.
As a young girl, Santosh was not ready to accept anything unreasonable. As where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh was preferring shorts. From the very beginning, she said that she will choose the correct and rational path. The others around had to change, not her. She didn't want to marry at early age, and she wanted a higher education.
Okay. Why was Santosh sent to the local school? See, the parents were so affluent. What is the meaning of affluent? Yes. Rich and wealthy. So they could afford very easily to send their daughter for higher education to another city. They could afford her fees. They could afford her hostel accommodation charges, etc. But why she was not sent to that? Why was she sent only to the local school in that village here where she was living? What was the reason behind that? Last boy, Pranay. You come here.
Uh,
Santosh's parents were rich landowners who were afford to send their child to the best schools, but she was sent to the local school because of the prevailing custom in their family. In their society, there was only aim to make the girl enough to enable to read and write. So that's why Santosh was also sent to the local school.
So very nicely, he has written. Now, Renuka, you come.
Santosh's parents were very healthy landowners. They can afford very higher studies for Santosh. But still, she went to a local school because at that time, the girls were not allowed to go for higher studies. This was against their traditions.
Santosh was born in a wealthy family who can easily afford the best education of their child. But because of all stereotypes in the society, that is, a girl was not allowed to do higher studies. She was sent to a local school. Yes.
Because of the stereotype nature of the villagers, stereotype nature of the society, family. So that's why she was not sent to another village or another town or city for higher education. She had to enroll in the same village. Okay, no doubt the family was rich enough, wealthy, affluent. They could easily afford. Okay, but they dare not send their daughter to another city. So next question we have is, when did she leave home for Delhi and why? So what was the time when she left for higher education? She moved to Delhi, and what was the reason behind that? Go through the text, find out. Okay, Kavarnur, you come. Find out, gather content for that. What was the reason? Aparan?
As Santosh's parents wanted the little girl who desired to attain education to get married, she refused their proposal and wanted to attain proper education. So at age of 16, she left home for Delhi to attain education.
See, in this answer, you will be writing that at the age of 16, when other girls of her age, they all were getting married because there was a custom and tradition to get married at the age of near about 16. So when she was also pressurized by her family, by her society, that she should also get married at this age, so she opposed them and she thought, no, education should be given more priority. Education should be given more importance as compared to marriage. So that's why she opposed her parents. She went to Delhi for higher education because she wanted to stand on her feet. She wanted to accumulate education. She wanted to be educated first because at that time she thought that it was really unreasonable to get married at the early age of 16, first of all, she should be educated enough, only then she should get married. So society was against this thing, family was also against this thing. So that's why she had to take a hard step, and she moved from that place and she went to Delhi. Is it clear? Okay, so same answer, Simran, you come and speak. After Simran, Jaskirat, you should be ready.
Santosh was born in a rich family. Though Santosh's parents could arrange a good school for their daughter, as they were rich, they could arrange everything for her, but still sent to her local school. Stereotypes and thinking of villagers was also not approving. And the last thing on the mind of Santosh's parents was her marriage at an early age, because every villager in their
city used to do this to their girls or daughters, but Santosh opposed this and rejected their proposal to get married because she wanted a good education first and threatened her parents that if they did not give her good education, she wouldn't get married. So as Santosh possessed every leadership quality in herself, so she took a hard step and got enrolled in a school in Delhi.
You come, whatever you have written, single line or two line, whatever you have written, come here.
At the age of 16, she left home for education and went to Delhi for education because her parents refused to pay for her education. At that time, the girl should marry at the age of 16, but Santosh wanted to be educated and then get married.
Okay, you have well tried. Daljeet, you come. After Daljeet, Saksham should be ready.
Santosh left home for Delhi at the age of 16 because she was under pressure to get married, but she refused the narrow thoughts and stereotypes of the society. She said that she would never marry if she didn't get a proper education.
When she turned 16, at the age of the 16, most of the girls of her village used to get married. Santosh was under pressure for her parents to do the same, but she opposed her parents. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she don't get proper education. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi.
Okay, now let's move to next question. Why did Santosh's parents agree to pay for her schooling in Delhi? What mental qualities of Santosh are brought into light by this incident? See, earlier when Santosh took this hard step that she is going to move in another town or city for higher education, and parents became so annoyed. They got so angry that first of all, they refused to pay her fees. But afterwards, when Santosh made up her mind that she would be working part-time and she would be paying her own fees, so then parents had to take some another step. They became sympathetic. They felt pity on their daughter that how would she cope up, how would she make balance between her education, between gaining her education and between earning also. So it was very difficult to pay fees. Okay, so that's why they had to change up their mind. They were ready to pay her fees. They were ready to enroll her for higher education. So what mental qualities of Santosh are brought into light? What kind of qualities that come in front of us? Daring, very good. She was bold, daring. Okay, you pick. You are saying that she was bold, daring. Okay, you are saying courageous. Okay, you are saying she was determined. Yes. Yes, her nature was full of sacrifice. She stand on her decisions, firm. Stand for the truth. Passionate for her dreams. Self-dependent. Responsible, self-dependent. So there were so many steps, there were so many traits you can take. Start writing about that. by the time I mark attendance of online student, you frame this answer. You write down as many as pairs you can write down. So, bachche, write down today's attendance. Aryan, Dhiren, Jayati, Kriti Verma, Parmeet Singh, Ridhima, Ritik Kapoor, Sudiksha, Sumati, Ikjot Kaur, Divyanshi. Okay, so who is going to tell me this answer? Okay, Laksh, you come forward.
Santosh parents agreed. Santosh parents agreed to pay for her education when she informed them that she would earn money by working time part-time and pay her school fees. This showed that Santosh was determined and a strong and willed girl who would do anything to achieve her goals.
Okay, Divya, you come and speak. After Divya, Kirti Singh. And after Kirti, Vanshika should be ready. Come in front of camera. Speak loudly. Keep your mic up.
She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. She left home and got herself enrolled in a school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. Her ethics of choosing right, affirmative and bold thinking and dynamic qualities are brought into the light by this incident. She was hardworking young lady who was firm on her decisions. She was very passionate about her decisions.
Okay, very well written. She has framed good vocabulary words, arranged all the ideas so nicely.
When parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. There, so many mental qualities for Santosh was brought into light by the incident. Like, she is very passionate and is bold. And she is bold.
Okay. So you can write down about her traits also, about her qualities. That some of the qualities are written on blackboard. You can pick up all those traits also, add up some points from your side, then mention the reasons also why you think that these traits she possesses. Afterwards, to whom I called? Wait, everybody will be given a chance to speak.
When Santosh demanded for higher education, parents got angry and denied to pay her fees because her decision was against the rules of society. So she made her plans to work part-time and pay her fees herself. But the parents got sympathized on her and agreed to pay her fees. Number of mental qualities like boldness, daring, courageous, determined, full of sacrifices, etc. were bring into light by this incident.
Was brought into light. Not bring into light. Was brought into light. So this answer is clear. One more girl I'm going to call.
Santosh parents agreed to pay her schooling in Delhi when she threatened her parents that she would never get married and she decided to do part-time job and she would pay her fees on her own. So their parents feel pity on her and decided to pay her schooling in Delhi as it is very difficult to work as well as study. She was very daring and she was determined about her goals. Her nature was sacrificing as she took a hard step to do part-time job and as well as study. She was passionate about her decisions. So these qualities were brought into light by this incident.
So these five answers are clear to you? Will be able to do in your fair notebook? So today, whatever the questions we have discussed today, you do in your fair notebook. Tomorrow also same chapter will be going on. On Wednesday, you will have a holiday. On Wednesday, you will be having holiday. So on Thursday, I will be collecting your English notebooks. Up to this chapter, whatever the writing skills we have done, whatever the question answers we have done, you jot down side by side. On Thursday, I will collect all the notebooks. I don't want to listen any kind of excuse. Up to this, I will be checking what happened basically there. Kavarnur, it is a fair of the Sarah. You are roaming here and there. It is a classroom. Who told you to come here without taking permission? You are roaming in my class. Oh, there. My chapter is not finished. I am giving only instructions. What to do till Wednesday? And you started roaming as free period is going on. Now let's move to second part of the question. How did Santosh begin to climb mountains? See where she was living? Hostel. So there he got a chance to see at Aravali Hills. So where people were going up. So she was attracted towards them. She also tried. So from there, she got the, you can say, spirit that what she wanted to be. What was her desire? She inclined to that passion. So after that, she became so passionate. She wanted to join them. When she joined them, she thought that she should go in that line. Okay? So how did Santosh begin to climb mountains? Okay. Now the bell has gone. Up to these five answers you do in your fair notebooks.